am your English teacher, Dr. Hacı Uğur. I graduated from Selçuk University, Turkey, and then Leeds University, England. As you know that, I am from Kırşehir, like Neşeter Taş. Kırşehir is one of the most beautiful cities in Turkey. You should go there and visit historical places, and of course, drink tea and listen to the things of Neşeter Taş. My friends, we studied English together with 41 videos and some storybook videos and finished A1 level. Now we are studying A2 level. You should study very hard and watch our videos every day. I think you are ready. And now, if you are ready, let's start our lesson together. Hello friends, are you ready? Let's start then. My dear friends, now we are studying imperative sentences. First, for example, open your book. Okay, and the second picture, raise your hand. It means that. And the third picture, sit down, as you see. Okay, open your book, raise your hand, and sit down. And the other, we have got two pictures. A boy is going out, I think. We say, go out. And second picture, close your books. Go out, close your books. And the other one, we have got, sorry my friend, three pictures. First picture, a boy. What can we say? Go to the library. And the other picture, stand up. Okay, and the other, repeat after me. Bird, bird. Okay, go to the library, stand up, repeat after me. And again, we have got two pictures. First picture, listen to me. And the other picture, what can we say? The man is about to start running. We say, start. And the other one, close the door. Listen to me, start, close the door. And again, we have got two pictures. What can we say? Draw a picture. And the girl is drawing a picture. And second picture, a handsome man. I think he is a teacher. What can he say? Listen to me. Draw a picture. Listen to me. And we have got three pictures. First picture, open the door. Open the door. Second, write your name. And finish. All of them are imperative sentences. No subject. Directly we start with verbs. Open the door, write your name, finish. And now, negative imperatives. Don't make noise. Okay, negative imperatives. Second, don't sleep. Don't sleep. And don't throw, no throw. Don't throw. Now, repeat after me. Don't make noise. Don't sleep. Don't throw. And we have got two pictures. First picture, what can we say? Oh, well, we say, don't chat in the exam. Because they are talking, I think the teacher is angry and says, children, don't chat in the exam. Okay. And the second picture, there are two boys, or a boy and a girl. They are drawing or writing something else on the desk. What can we say? Don't write on the desk or don't draw on the desk, also we say. Yes, don't chat in the exam, don't write on the desk. First picture, a boy is playing football. Don't play in the class. Don't play in the class. And other girl chewing gum, I think. What can we say? Don't chew gum. It's forbidden. And the other, the girl is running. Where in the class? What can we say? Don't run in the class. Now, let's repeat them together. First me, then you. Don't play in the class. Don't chew gum. Don't run in the class. And now, give me a sharpener. Please, give me a sharpener. It is an also order. And now, a school bag. Give me a school bag. Or, give me a pencil. And now we have got two pictures. What can we say? First picture, give me a book, give it me. And the other, give me a pencil case. They are order, they are imperative sentences. Give me a book, give me a pencil case. And the other one, we have got again one, two, three pictures. We say, give me a pen, give me a uniform, give me a ball. Okay, they are all orders or imperative sentences. Give me a pen, give me a uniform, give me a ball. And my friends, it is now the time to choose the correct ones. Okay, we have got three pictures. We are choosing the correct one. Look at the picture and say, what is this? First picture, school bag. Second picture, pencil. The other one, computer. We say, school bag, pencil, computer. And the other one, first picture, paint brush. It's called paint brush. The second one, scissors. And the other one, paper clips. Paintbrush, scissors, and paper clips. And again, first picture, pencil case, ruler, notebook. Okay, repeat please. Pencil case, ruler, notebook. And now my friends, now we are studying prices. For example, look at the first picture. I think it is chocolate. It's, we say, 1 pound 50 pence. But we say it's 1 pound 50. Okay. And the other one, it's 10 pounds. Okay. First picture, it's 1 pound 50, and the other one, it's 10 pounds. Okay, let's go on. First picture, there is a bag. How much is it? It's 15 pounds, not pound, pounds. Pound is English money. We have got Turkish liras. British people use pound. Okay, my friends. And the second, it's 2 pounds 25. Okay, it's 15 pounds, it's 2 pounds 25. And again, a desk, oh, it's so expensive. It's 41 pounds 75. And a tie, it's 7 pounds, I think expensive. And the other, an orange, it's, oh, very cheap, 25p, but only one. It's 25 pence. Okay, my friend. Pence, 100 pence is 1 pound or 1 sterling. And the other picture, it's 20 pence, but written 30 pence, no problem. Let's go on. It's 75 pence. And the other picture, it's 63 pence. They are pence, not pound. Okay, my friends. And the other picture, tomato juice. Oh, it's 87 pence. And a hot dog, how much is it? It's 45 pence. It's 87 pence, it's 45 pence. As you see that, we are perfect. So, you should like and share us. Please, my friend, repeat and repeat. Study very, very hard.